Okay, so I'm illustrating a book which is incredible. I didn't think I would have this opportunity so soon, and I've got a lot of mixed emotions about it because on the one hand I'm obviously really excited, but on the other there's a smudge on the lens. On the one hand, I'm obviously really excited about it. It's a great opportunity. But on the other, I am nervous that I'm not going to be able to do the job properly. I'm scared that I'm going to fuck it up. And there's also a lot, there's complicated emotions around the story behind the book is really emotional. I won't get too in detail about it right now, but there is a documentary about it. But the story is about Breck Bednar, and he was groomed online and he was manipulated, and I really want to do his story justice because it is so important. It's so important to raise awareness around this, and it's so important that other children know the dangers. He just thought he'd met a friend online. He thought he met someone he could look up to. He thought this person was going to help him in his career, in the career he wanted. He thought this person was there for him. He thought this person understood him like no one else. When I was reading up about this story and watching the documentary, it was heartbreaking. I met with the guy who kind of started the project for the book. He's really lovely, by the way. This is actually quite new for him as well. He's never done something like this, which is quite nice to know that you're not the only person who is like new to the whole thing. But he informed me that he wanted, even though this story is for children, he wanted the illustrations to be quite dark and quite realistic. So, which I think might be controversial to children, to give to children to tell this story. Because it is about death, it's about murder, it's about child predators. But on the other hand, we can't wrap our children in bubble wrap forever. We can't pretend that these things aren't happening. We can't pretend that this isn't happening on a daily basis. Just having a quick chat about not talking to strangers isn't gonna cut it. So I've made a few very rough sketches so far. Today I'm going to really try to expand on them, to really flesh out my ideas properly and do this properly, because I really want to do the story justice. I really want to do a good job on this. This is a story that needs to be told well. People need to hear about it. And I'm really honoured, I'm really excited, I'm really humbled that I get to be a part of this project. And it's a bit daunting because I've been given the manuscript of the children's book. I have been given not a huge amount of direction. I have pretty much complete creative freedom with the illustrations. Obviously there are elements that have to go to this brief, but the guidelines aren't very specific. I can pretty much interpret the manuscript however I want. So on the one hand, that's amazing. I get to completely illustrate the story with complete creative freedom. But on the other hand, it's kind of scary because there are so many ways I can do it. And what if the way that I do it isn't the way that the family likes or doesn't really, I don't know, go with the story? I'm not used to doing anything like this. It's so new for me. I've only done a couple commissions. I've only really done my own work, and I don't really have to please anyone when I do that. If someone wants it, they can buy it, and I don't have to. I'm not starting the painting knowing that someone is waiting for it, someone is looking, is gonna look at it, and they're gonna judge it because they have an image in their head of what they wanted it to look like. I really just want to get all my ideas on paper, know what I'm gonna do, plan an illustration for each part of this story, each page, and I thought I would document the process, document how this whole thing works, because it's something that I have always been curious about, and I don't think that this is necessarily the normal process you go through when you're illustrating a book, because for one, this is for a charity, it's not necessarily for a publishing company. The way I was picked for this project, it was just luck that a friend of mine was approached because they knew someone, and this friend recommended me because she thought that I would do a great job on one of these books, because there's going to be two, and there's also going to be a play, which is really great. He's covering like all formats. So yeah, this whole process is really new and exciting and daunting, and I just thought it might be useful to share. Okay, so studies are all done. I basically know what I'm doing now. I sent them over to the guy, Mark, that's kind of organising this project, and he seemed to really like them, which is cool. He's going to send them over to Lauren, which is Breck's mum. I'm hoping she likes them, because it's obviously really important to her, so I want to make sure that she's happy with everything. As I was looking into the project, into the family and stuff, I've just realised how much work she's really put into getting Breck's name out there and getting a story out there. Like, she's been going to classrooms, she's trying to organise plays and books and like all sorts of stuff. And she's like been in a couple different documentaries, so that's really cool. I was talking to my mum about it, and she was like, well, yeah, obviously if your child has died, you want to make sure that everyone knows your name, everyone knows their name, that you won't rest until something good has come of it. I'm hoping I get started on the main like illustration soon. It's been a bit hectic around here because we've had the floors redone, so kind of everything's been rearranged. I've got a table in my room and some canvases and a dog's cage and everything. Like, it's just been a bit hectic, so it's been quite hard to concentrate, but the floors are done now, so we just have to put everything back in its place. So hopefully I can get started soon. I've only got my room to work in. I've only got this like desk. This is kind of my whole art space, so there's not really anywhere else I can go to work, so I kind of have to just go with the flow of whatever's going on in the house. I have to go to my part-time job now. I work at Tesco. So hopefully when I get home today at 6, things will be a lot more organised around here, because my mum has a day off, so she's gonna like try and organise the rooms and stuff. Oh yeah. Sent all the thumbnails to the guy that is organising it, Mark. He has spoken with a few people, and with the mum, Lauren, and like they've talked about how they want the overall look to be, and the feedback I received was positive, really positive overall, which is great. He had a few changes to some of the concepts. I think he said some of them were too abstract for young children to get, which I completely agree with. I think I just got a little bit caught up trying to make things very versatile and varied and different and creative, and I kind of forgot that 4-year-olds are reading this and they're not going to understand what that picture means if it's not like a lot more simple. So for some of them it's just small tweaks, but for others I'm going to have to completely change it. It's going to be a completely new illustration. A lot of them have stayed the same, which is great, so I can just make a start on those. And I think I'm just going to make a start on the illustrations that I know what I'm doing. I'm gonna make a start on some actual full illustrations and then do the thumbnails closer to the time of actually doing it. So I've made a lot of progress on the first one. I think it looks pretty good. I still need to do a few tweaks on it, and then I'm gonna start doing some of the preliminary sketches for some other ones. And that's it, that's where I am at the minute. If there are any significant developments, I will let you know. Here is the third illustration in the book. I'm kind of struggling with it, to be honest. I don't know why, but it just feels a bit wrong. Something just feels off about his face. His mouth is like weird. I'm gonna try and fix that. But something else just feels off about his face. I don't know, maybe it's because of the lighting. He's supposed to be looking at a computer, so I tried to have the lighting go up. And when maybe, oh, I just don't know, man. Like, do you ever just have that feeling? I talked to my mum about it, and I usually trust her opinion quite a lot, because she doesn't just tell me nice things just because she's my mom. Like, she actually gives me genuine criticism, but she said that she couldn't see any serious problems with it. But I don't know if I believe that, because I'm just kind of looking at it and I hate it a little bit, and I don't know why exactly. But I've already gone in with a little bit of gouache to kind of fix a few things, and I think I'm going to continue with that. Maybe add like some kind of greenish highlights, because I feel like that works really well with brown hair, because I don't know, it kind of just makes it look less boring and muddy, and with the kind of light from the computer I feel like it would look quite good. So yeah, I'm going to do that and we'll see what happens. We'll see if I can make it something that I actually really like. So I did manage to fix the issues with this illustration, and I think it came together to something that I was quite happy with. And at this point in the project, that I was really seeing kind of the whole project was coming together. I had quite a lot of finished illustrations to the point where like it was actually like on its way to being a fully realized project, and I could actually see the finished, like the end of like the project in my mind, and it was like becoming quite real, and I was just kind of like, oh my god, like I'm actually doing this, like I'm actually illustrating a book, like this is happening. It was just kind of weird just spending all this time on this like one project, and like it kind of was like, oh, I'm actually like doing this, I'm actually being professional, but at the same time I had this kind of imposter syndrome of like, I shouldn't be doing this, I should not be illustrating a book, this is like high level this isn't for me. But I reckon like a lot of people feel like that when they're first taking on like actual proper projects for their creative like work. But I was surprised at how well things were going. I didn't have to remake any paintings, and I was like, I'm actually not bad at this, which is quite lucky, because I did have like a time crunch, so it would have been a bit of a nightmare if I had to spend like a week on a painting and then had to remake it. But yeah, everything was working out, so I was like really happy. Okay, so it is finally quiet enough in my house that I can talk to you guys. So, I haven't really documented much of the process for the book lately since the first few illustrations, so I thought I would give a quick update on how it's going, where I'm at, etc. It's going pretty well. I'm almost done with it. It's exciting. I've got like 3 illustrations left to do, I think. Double check. So yeah, I've got 1 to finish and 3 to actually start. So yeah, it's going pretty well. Nearly done. I'm really excited.
did. So I've got this one to do some last details on, and then I've got this one to start. I've just been doing some sketches on that, and then I've got this one to scan, and I'll finish the other one before I scan that one, so I can scan both together. And I'm also going to scan this painting, which is a personal painting. It's not to do with the project, but yeah, I'm going to scan that anyway. So what to tell you? So basically what's been happening is I have been just working on the illustrations, scanning them, sending them over to Mark, who is kind of running the project. I mentioned him ages ago. So I send him the scans. He gives me feedback on them and about the future illustrations, kind of the vibe he's going for. Any tips, any changes he wants me to make, etc. So I'm pretty much, everything's going through him, and he gives me news about the kind of businessy end, because he's still trying to figure out how he's going to get the books out and etc. So recently he told me that the board of directors has decided that the books are going to be their next fundraising aim. They aim to raise enough funds to get a teacher edition and child edition of the books into every special needs school in the UK. Exciting. So it looks like it's going pretty well. And he also recently told me that they agreed on 5% royalties for me to get after the books being published and stuff. So that's cute. Overall, I'm really happy. I feel like I have worked really hard. I'm really happy with the outcomes that I've made. It's been a lot of work, so much work. It's taken ages to do this. I feel like it's just such a huge project, dude. Such a huge project. It's taken a lot of time. I feel like it's taken over my entire life, because I have had such little time for personal paintings and just for life, because I'm trying to get all this stuff done and I'm just so focused on this project. And it's great, honestly, it's great. I'm really happy I'm doing it, and it's such an amazing opportunity, but to be honest, I would not do a project this big again. Really wouldn't. It's just such a huge commitment, especially because I don't want to be a dick about it, but the payment I feel like is not really worth what I'm actually putting into it. But if it was just for a financial standpoint, it's not really worth it. But because this is an opportunity for me to get my name out there, and also it's for a charity, so you have to take that into account. So from that standpoint, it's worth it, but from a purely financial one, it's not. And if it was under different circumstances, if I was at a different point in my career, if it was for a different company, not a charity, and if it was for a different cause, then I don't think I would do this again. But I feel like this is kind of a message that's important, so I feel like putting the time and the effort into this is important for me to do, and it feels like I'm actually doing something that feels right. So I'm kind of happy to make those sacrifices, you know? Ooh, it's about 11:30 now and I'm getting kind of tired, but I'm so close to finishing the project that I really just want to get it done today, and then I don't have to worry about it anymore. I know it's all finished. I know it's going to be an amazing feeling. So I'm just trying to push myself to finish it, but at the same time, I don't want to half-ass it, you know? I want to actually do my best work. And I'm kind of worried that if I push through, then it will just mean I'm rushing through to get it done and not actually doing my best work, which would be kind of because this is the first real big project that I've ever done. So I'm gonna, if I catch myself getting sloppy, I have to stop and just finish it, not tomorrow because I've got work, but on Sunday. I have to just finish it on Sunday, but I would love to just finish it today. I'm so close. It's looking pretty good. I'm really happy with everything so far. It's just the last stretch. I've got the last two that I'm about halfway through, and if I could just maybe stay up another couple hours and get it done. It's been a few days since I finished the project, and I put finished in quotation marks because I forgot the cover, which is pretty important.
I don't know why it slipped my mind, the actual cover of the book, but yeah, I completely forgot about it, and I still need to do that. So I'm gonna email Mark, ask him about the cover, because we kind of spoke a little bit about an ideas, but we never really landed on what exactly the cover was supposed to be. I also have like a couple of tiny details to finish on one of the illustrations. I need to scan them, edit the photos, send everything off, so that's what I'm gonna do today. So after talking with Mark, it turned out I didn't actually have to do an extra illustration for the cover, because they were gonna use one of the ones that were I'd already finished that were in the book for the cover. I think the first one, where it's just a picture of Breck, like, just smiling and looking happy. So I just did some of the other stuff that I needed to do, scanning, editing, sending everything off, and, like, that just took up most of that day, and it was quite chill. Yeah, as I'm recording this voiceover right now, this is actually way, way later after I finished everything, and it's only just starting to be published, and I wanted to finish this video and put everything together so I could talk about it. I've almost forgotten, like, kind of how it felt when I was doing the project, and it was, like, at that point in time. Yeah, I just want to say that overall I am really happy with the work that I did. I worked really hard, I'm quite proud of myself, and I'm really excited to see like the final product once it's all been put together and published, and I can actually like have a copy and see all my work together in this book. And my friend is also working on, well, she's finished now obviously, but she worked on the other book, and I can see how that turned out, and it's just all really exciting. It's a great opportunity for me, and like it's like literally been one of my entire life goals to illustrate a book, so it was quite surreal when I actually got to do it. So I just want to say a huge thank you to Mark, to everyone else that was involved in the project and kind of like made this happen, and I can't wait to like actually see the finished result. And like, it's actually like just so crazy to me that I got to do this. So amazing, I'm so happy, and I hope this video was helpful to anyone that's curious about this sort of process and would like to get involved in anything like this and kind of like see how stuff like that actually comes together. So yeah, I hope everyone's doing well and staying safe. Talk to you soon. Hey, so yeah, psych, video's not actually over. Video, so if you're still here, I really appreciate it, thank you. Just in the post, and I thought it'd be cool to include it, so it is the actual published final book. After all this time, I've actually got it, and I'm actually looking at it, and it's actually in my hands, and it actually says my name on it. I'm actually, it's such like an overwhelming weird feeling to know that like it's actually here. Like it doesn't even feel real until like I'm actually holding it in my hands. Like I illustrated this book, and people are gonna buy it and read it, and it's actually real. Mad. Yeah, so I thought I'd just show you what it looks like and give a little flip through and stuff, and yeah. There's like teaching activities and stuff, and like stuff that you can do with kids that's like related to the topic and everything. So yeah. Okay, so here's like a close-up view of the cover. It's got my little name there, written by Mark Harrington, who I worked with on the project. I'll just give you a little flick through of some of the illustrations in it and stuff, how they look like. They've like, I think they probably edit them a little bit, because I think a lot of the contrast is like up on a lot of the illustrations and stuff, but yeah, it looks pretty much how I thought it would. And yeah, there's all the little worksheets in the back and stuff. But yeah, it's quite cool. I like it. But actually include the final product and kind of give the whole video like a complete feel. But yeah, I think this would be a really cool tool to use if you do want to teach kids about online safety, which is quite an important subject to talk about with your kids. Like, I remember being like 13 going on Omegle and just seeing like quite gross stuff on there. Like one of those like nasty dudes on there could have easily like groomed me. Like I just didn't really think about that. Well, I think when I was younger there was less focus on online safety. It was just because it's like more of a new thing. Because I was a, you know, 90s baby, is just like, yeah. But literally anyone could be in a dangerous situation because of this. I could have been in so many dangerous situations because I didn't take online safety seriously, because I wasn't taught about it, because I didn't know about it. So yeah, this is a great resource. And if you want to learn more about it, if you just want to support the charity, like I will link below where you can buy this, and like there's a couple other books that are published at the same time. So yeah, I'll link to that. And yeah, if you made it to the end of this video, which I'm pretty sure is like I don't know, like over half hour at this point, then yeah, thanks a lot, and hopefully I will see you in another video.